fans. I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Ohio State Buckeyes and the Indiana Hoosiers. Number 23 is the player we're focusing on in this game tonight.
This kid provides the sparks of offense and defense for his squad, Brad. You can't find a more valuable player to his team.
The Hoosiers will clearly rely on him to make contributions on both ends of the floor. The Hoosiers might have a little trouble with these guys, Dick. Keys to their success depends on what?
Hey, the keys to their success tonight are simple. Number one, make their outside shooters into drivers. Attack them, be aggressive on the D. Next, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. And lastly, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that. Trying to go inside. Turnover City, now always really negate any offense.
Gant receives the pass. For two. The lay-in. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
Trying to feed inside and up and sinks it. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense.
Up and inside.
Here's the three ball. Makes it. Look at the student section, Dick, cheering on their classmates, their peers. If you ask any coach or player, I'm sure they'll say that the student section is the best.
Aren't they great, Brad? I love it.
Boy, terrible execution on offense. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on the basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively.
Dump it inside.
Pope picks up the foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
He goes to the line, shooting two. He hits the first. The second. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass. Got to pass it or make a play, Brad.
For the bucket. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
I'm sorry, Brad, but this young fella seems to be their only hope at the moment.
Takes the pass in the paint. Leans in. Martin makes the finger roll. On the outside. Dumps it in. Number 31 receives the ball from downtown. There was no doubt about that one. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Tries for two.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
To get it to the inside. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Gant handles the pass from right of the circle. Gant makes a trade.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
The center handles the feed. Jumps into the defender. Pops is asking the fans to get behind his team right now.
He's asking for a bit more on the next possession.
Side three, got it. Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to drop. And he's going to pick up the foul. And oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach. If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. Left him a nylon, NBA.
Working it around the perimeter. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. The skip pass is picked off. He makes a nice shot fake. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
Completely alone.
Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. And it really converts an offensive transition.
There's a bad pass right to the defender with a long bomb. Little whistle blown, basket's good, and one.
That's concentration, baby.
Look at him, Dick. He's trying to pump up the crowd. He and his team have made a series of great plays, and boy, do they have the momentum now.
Hey, he wants everyone to get up.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Play created a foul opportunity. That's a 7-0 run.
He up fakes.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Stolen away. And back they come the other way. What do you think, Dick?
They need a timeout here, Brad. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck. Where's he going?
For two. They still don't score. For the bucket. Up and in. Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position. Has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
gets a hand in the way. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Jumps in. Indiana have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
Makes the shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For two.
He used the screen perfectly to put in the inside hoop.
Gave it up. And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Leaning in, trying to draw contact.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Dickey's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
And his shot rejected. Ball goes out of play. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, he seemed very focused from the beginning. His game face was on, and he understands it's his time to perform. Let's send it back to you.
Shoots. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
The Buckeyes seem to be living the good life these days, Dick. With all their recent success, now they're regulars at the NCAA tournament.
Hey, being successful isn't easy, Brad. Your program must be solid from top to bottom in order to be successful.
He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Going to move it around the perimeter. Donahue fakes the shot. Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. He shoots from the top of the key. Great shot. Picked off. They move it into the front court. Defense taking away any open looks. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, that's a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
And they get the turnover. On the dribble, gives it up. Fakes a jumper. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Taken away. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I'll tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
For the bucket, the Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
Picks off the pass. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
takes. And he'll kick it back outside.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team. They look like they're having a blast.
Donahue comes up with it. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. Tries for two, and off the mark. Trying to draw some contact. He drains it. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
Thanks, Aaron.
I'll tell you one thing, you better be able to establish post play because that gives you inside-outside action. Look at that spacing.
Here's a double team. He fires from long range. He shows the sweet touch. Perimeter. They'll work it around the arc. He gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
Jumped in front to take it away. Transition opportunity coming up. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
He lets it go. He buries the shot.
Wow, that's worth the price of admission.
Makes the shot. With a little baby hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot. I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
He strokes it. He gets another one to go.
This is a shooting clinic, my friend.
On the outside, he tries the three. Gets it to fall. Picks off the lazy pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Intercepted. He shoots from left of the circle, way off target. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
The man is off the charts, Brad.
He puts it in with contact and all. He puts up the three ball. Got it. On the outside, on the dribble, gives it up. Alley-oop. And the ball goes out of play. Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket. Steal, go up the other way, get a layup. Good athletic move. Very athletic. He's got great athleticism.
It looks as though the students are all wound up and ready to agitate the opposition.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Gave it up for the bucket. Can't get the shot to drop.
Hey, Brad, this youngster is showing how to put the clamp on a player defensively.
Spectacular defensive effort. He intercepts it. They work the perimeter. He pulls the trigger. Nice shot.
Cue the rewind button, boys.
On the dribble, gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against it, and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They push it up on the break. Looking for the foul. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Nick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
Now this is home court advantage at its best. The crowd, the students, everyone is feeling good. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Tries for two.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby. Double team now, bad angle. They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
Gave it up. Martin, he gets the foul, and the layup will count, Dick.
Hey, way to play strong, my man. Way to play strong.
The Buckeyes are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. Gets it. Looking for contact. Basket falls despite the contact.
Two for one opportunity.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Great elevator man, man. That's the elevator guy. What a high riser.
Shot clock is dead. The Buckeyes have a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
Looking for a good shot. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Foul charge. And, Dick, look at this sellout crowd, and they are loving it.
Oh, they're ecstatic, baby. They're ecstatic. Great team play. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up for two.
I love this guy, Hook. You can't unblock that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
At the half, the Buckeyes are down by eight. Well, Dick, so far we've got a close one. Any play that sticks out to you as the highlight of the half?
The threes were the key for me, Brad. In my books, this shot sparked morale more than anything. When you're hitting threes, everything else comes a lot easier.
It's time to get back to the court, Dick, and see how this second half plays out. Indiana is showing tremendous accuracy from the floor in the first half, partner.
They're so well coached, man. Working the ball around for the high percentage shot, that's a lot of maturity, man. They really are a mature basketball team.
Dick started the second half. We take a look at our focus player, and he's going to have to be the man to come through.
Well, I think he's got to attack the basket a lot more. I think he's got to get opportunities to go to the free throw line, and that'll come if he becomes aggressive. Inside
for two, and he scores despite the half.
have to see that one again.
Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They strip him in the basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
For the bucket.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Takes away the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Takes it off him. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots, good opportunities? The team which takes care of these things usually is in a better position to win a game.
Around the perimeter. Up fake. He squares up that and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Off the rim and no good. Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
Steals a pass. The crowd loves this young man.
Yeah, they really know how to show their appreciation for him.
The Hoosiers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Definitely a foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He is going to the line. He makes the first.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus. It's BMOC. Big man on campus, baby. Look at that great defense right there. Not allowing him to make the turn.
He's got a high post flasher. Puts it up, looking for contact. It's good. The Hoosiers lead by 9. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Stolen ball. Looking for a good shot. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. Perfectly executed.
He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Tries for 2. Ohio State is showing a bit of a run here.
Things are going their way right now.
He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way.
great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane. Anticipated really well.
On the outside, obvious foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Got a man in high post. He shoots from the top of the circle, way off target. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Pressure that basketball.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Nick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
From three-point territory.
Wow, what a super job of running his man into the screen for that sweet jumper. There's the trap.
Stolen away. Nelson is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
Emotionally, he needs some inspiration.
He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gotta eliminate those turnovers.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Trying to draw the foul.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer.
Looking for a good shot. He shoots from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. Ohio State are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together here.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense. Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Goes for the deep one. The Hoosiers are ahead by five. Adam, momentary look from three-point land, goes in.
This is what posters are made from. He missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. He's got an open look for the shot. Top of the circle, he hits the shot. The Buckeyes trail by five. And the fans are going wild.
You're right. The student sections, the bands, and the crowd are always urging their team to victory like a sixth man.
There's the fake, and he'll kick it back outside. Puts up the tray. He hits it. He attempts a jump hook. Dickie's simply on fire.
Hey, call the fire department, baby. This one's burning up.
Moving it around the perimeter.
See, first, initially, he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. But good rebounding position, a good block out. And that's essential in a post. A lot of guys don't realize part of the post play is ultimately to block out and get good rebound position.
They work it around the perimeter.
Got to take some pride on the defensive end.
They're dialing threes up like nothing right now.
Hey, this is awesome to watch, baby.
He He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up. He was attacking the basket.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
From the top of the key, he's money with the shot. This school is known for football. It's great to see that the basketball program is now getting some of that attention.
Hey, their football team is great, but their basketball program is starting to turn some heads.
Here they come with a double team to stop it. Tries to get the D to bite. He shoots from right of the circle. He hits the tough shot.
Conte's knocking him down with ease, Brad.
That was a high post screen. Goes to the lane.
Three. He gets it to go. He shoots from the top of the key. Sinks the shot.
Let's see that up close.
To pick up the defense here now. He strips him clean. And he'll kick it back outside. He takes the shot. Ohio State are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Great defense. That's going to be a backcourt violation, Dick.
Hey, the defense did their job, baby.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Brad, despite his performance, he has been unable to get his teammates all on the same page. There's a lot of confusion and lack of focus down here right by the bench. He continues to stress to them, relax, play your game. He can't do this alone, Brad.
Look at that student body. They are going mad.
Oh, yes, the student body. Always full of comedy and excitement.
They work the perimeter. He takes a three.
Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job in post-defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
There's a double team waiting there. Perfectly executed.
Double team now, bad angle.
Good job defensively. Pass down the guy in the post to go the other way. He shoots from long range. Way off target. Steals the pass. He's got the man in the high post if he can get it there. Kicks it out. He unloads. Ohio State are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they have to keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
Diggy's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball and man.
For two. They're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
And now they'll bring it up. Steal. Defense got it after knocking it loose. That's going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge.
Leans in. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
There's the trap.
Gant comes up with it. And again, they look to run. Martin draws the personal. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me?
He'll visit the charity stripe. Sinks it. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Both shots good. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Try to come up with a steal, and they do. For the bucket.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
He intercepts it. Is feeling good.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
Makes the shot. This one is shaping up to be a barn burner, Dick.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
Intercepted. For two, Indiana are on a bit of a run.
Let's see how long they can keep it on, Brad.
Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
Those long arms trying to get him in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside though is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
That's a foul. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
The center takes the feed. He goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
Out of the air. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
10 seconds remaining on the shot clock.
Let's check out this replay, Brad.
around the arc. On the dribble, gives it up.
Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Robs him of the ball. For the bucket. Finger roll.
A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats.
Well, Dick, the shots seem to be dropping for him right now.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. They're dropping, and you better have good productivity out of your front court. When you have that balance inside-outside, you got a great chance to win. And you have to have post players that are going to make big plays.
Steal.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
Dick, he's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
And as you would say right here, Mr. Vitale, Flop City!
I tell you one thing, absolutely a flop. No doubt, Mr. Nestler.
Picked off. Sinks it. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Stolen. For the deuce. He puts it in with contact and all. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the arc.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The point guard with the ball. Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
The shooting guard gets the ball. Gave it up.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively. Great play to take that to the basket.
The power forward gets the pass. The ball goes out of play. Well, Mr. Vitale, let's take a look at our backcourt production.
Hey, I'll tell you one thing, Brad. You look at the stats, you want to find out if your backcourt is playing well. Well, you want to ensure that your guards keep the number of turnovers down. That's a must. Reduce turnovers. So many games are won or lost by teams turning the ball over. Turnovers, missed opportunities happen, baby, when you turn the rock over.
And the clock stopped with a foul. Well, Mr. Vitale, there's the foul situation so far.
Hey, Brad, staying out of foul trouble down the stretch of any game is vital. You want to keep your opponents off the free throw line and out of bonus situation.
And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, knowing when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their team.
Good. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. around the perimeter. The ball goes out of bounds. There's the turnover situation for the hat kick.
I tell you, the lower the number, the better off your team will be. With too many turnovers, the likelihood of you playing in a game at the end drops significantly.
Off the mark. Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he was sensational. He made all big shots. He really wanted the ball. I thought he was very aggressive offensively.
Indiana comes away with a win.
They expected to beat a victor. They just didn't expect it to be this close.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.